My name's Allie. I'm a senior project engineer with Howard S. Wright. We're building an office building for the City of Salem Public Works. Two stories, mass timber structure with some concrete, and I'll just have some offices and meeting space for the city.
It's early morning and we're getting ready to pour concrete on the second floor of our new structure. Started out with bringing the elevation up to grade, brought in about 2.5 feet of rock, poured foundations and a floor slab, and then the wood structure happened over the summer. We just completed the roof this last week, and we've begun pouring the second floor slabs. Concrete was chosen because it is the easiest to maintain. When it's polished to that nice shiny level, it's much easier to maintain and wears a lot. It's more durable than carpet.
The concrete deck we're pouring today is about 3 inches thick. It goes on top of our 4-inch mass plywood panels. And so we're pouring half of the north section, so it's about 45 yards.
So the concrete is gonna give that second floor the stiffness it needs so that it'll hold up everything that's happening up there. And part of it will actually be visible. We're gonna polish it to a nice fine shine, and so it'll be visible in the areas around the conference rooms especially. The structure is all wood and all locally sourced. So especially the plywood panels, which make up the roof and the basis for the floors, produced just up the river in the San Diego Canyon.
Some of the fun parts are just the fact that it is a mass timber building. And so this is one of the first projects that the mass plywood decks have actually been used.
The building's dried in. We're gonna have our floor slabs done in the next couple of weeks. And then it's all about interiors. So we're bringing in utilities now, putting in duct for HVAC. And it'll start going drywall and all the interior work so that we can move in early next fall.
I know the design team and owner team has done a really great job of just making the building feel welcoming and open and just a great space for the city and the public to kind of meet and get their work done. So I think that'll be really great once it opens. You'll be able to see just like some natural elements with all the wood and the concrete and just a great space.
My name's Evan Grimm, project manager for Howard S. Wright, general contractor. We're doing all the interior finish work, and as you can see, putting the exterior cladding systems on. We have a standing seam metal siding system with integral downspouts and gutters. The cladding for the shear walls is basically going to be a juniper board and batten system. These soffits, it's all tongue grooved juniper, which is through a restoration project from Central Oregon. So all that juniper is sourced here in Oregon. Oh, my favorite part of the building, it's got to be the mass timber elements and the exposed mass timber elements. It's just going to look fantastic. I mean, it's definitely a different type of construction. One of the aspects of utilizing mass timber construction is the desire to expose the structure. So just exposing the beautiful structure of wood. So you go through rigorous design, but also building all of this in a model to get it to be where it is now so that we can ensure when we go to install it, it's all gonna fit, it's all gonna be in the right spot. You're not gonna have any sort of rework where you have to reinstall something, because where you have, if you have exposed timber, if we were to have to move this over, we would unfortunately, you know, have to patch those holes. It's exposed. This is basically the main employee entrance here and their main break room. So this centralized stair will get all new wood treads on it. There'll be wood benches that are sort of built in around here. These are monitor windows. So these are both of these wings, this wing and the other wing, have north-facing monitor windows, which really provides indirect sunlight. What you're seeing here is all conference rooms. So finished wood casework, acoustical ceilings where they're getting them, even though most of these rooms, it's all exposed to the beautiful wood. tune back in a couple months and we'll really kind of revisit this area, and you'll definitely see it spring to life.
My name is Daniel Childs. I'm a project architect at Hacker Architects. The design build process is really a collaboration team approach with the contractors. So Howard S. Wright and Hacker work together from early design phase, from programming all the way through to construction, in a way that was like really flexible on budget, be able to test a lot of different fun ideas and different ways of doing this building. And it took us, you know, it really benefits the project by having us work together. So we have juniper siding here. This is called restoration juniper. It comes from around Bend area, eastern Oregon. When you walk in, you'll walk into the reception at the main lobby, where we have four reception area desks and then a large soft seating area with some tables. You can kind of see right through here, there's actually another door on the opposite side. And the way the building's oriented, that's known as the staff entry. Something very unique about this building is that we'd spent a lot of effort and energy making sure that you could see the structure. And so as you look around, you'll see the lights and the acoustic panel and the ductwork, all of that, the stuff that you would generally put behind or above a ceiling is all exposed, really showing how the building systems work and how the building operates in a building that's meant to work and operate for the city. The idea with the material is really to just celebrate or highlight the Oregon sort of resourced materials that we can get. We're standing right now in what's called one of our collaboration spaces. There's four in the building, and they happen sort of right next to this main stair on the north and the south. So it kind of corresponds back to the middle section of the building where we said all the collaboration happened. Where we have conference rooms, restrooms. The conference rooms are named after previous public works employees. The primary large conference room is called the John Bollinger conference room. And the big goals of the client and the city was to make sure that public works had a presence to the city and to all of the customers and people who come up and need to use the space.